Let's talk about diving into the deep ocean. About 71% of the Earth's surface has water in it. So, in addition to being able to fly, diving into the ocean has always been a dream for us. Are there any strange creatures down there? Are there any treasures? Is Atlantis there? Diving into the ocean is not that easy. The most challenging part of this is to overcome the pressure from the water. We know that as the depth goes up, the pressure goes up as well. You may ask me, how deep can a person dive without using any proper equipment? Well, so far, the record is 113 meters. So it is likely that this is close to the maximum pressure the human body can handle. I guess it's safe to say that if humans want to dive deeper, it would be impossible without using professional equipment. But when I say equipment, I don't mean oxygen tanks or these swimming goggles you can get at Walmart. I'm talking about submersibles. The world's first submersible was the Triest, designed by the Swiss scientist Auguste Piccard in 1951, but it was later bought by the US Navy in 1958. And finally, in 1960, it reached the ocean floor in the Challenger Deep, which is the deepest known point in Earth's ocean. The descent to the ocean floor took 4 hours 47 minutes. The onboard systems indicated a depth of 11,521 meters, although this was revised later to 10,916 meters. You may think that it is very difficult to build a submersible that can dive so deep, but creating a submersible that can not only dive but also completes tasks or does scientific experiments is just another story. The key component of a manned vessel is the pilot sphere that can withstand the enormous water pressure. It is so-called a pressure sphere. So how much pressure is there at 10,000 meters under the sea? Well, some say that it is equivalent to 2,000 elephants stepping on a person's back. Fun fact, the pressure sphere used in the deep sea Challenger that sent director James Cameron to the Challenger Deep was actually made from steel, and the diameter was only about a meter. So James could only dive to the bottom of Mariana Trench all alone and stayed there for nearly 3 hours. Man, I don't even know how I can stand in such a tiny space for that long. Apart from steel, a better material is titanium, a perfect material with low density and high strength that allows the vessel not only to bear water pressure at 10,000 meters, but also to reduce self-mass and expand interior space. On November 10th, China's independently developed and manufactured manned submersible Strever successfully dived to the Challenger Deep at 10,909 meters, setting a new record for China's manned deep diving. The pressure sphere of the Strever is also made of titanium. It can carry up to 3 scientists to perform exploration tasks by operating the robotic arms. Okay now, we know that we can build a titanium pressure sphere to withstand the pressure. But how does the submersible go up and go down? Well, in a nutshell, submersibles are ships that can adjust their buoyancy to be lighter or heavier than the surrounding water. If they are lighter than the water, they float like any other ship. If they're heavier than water, they sink below the surface. Well, think about this. When it dives to the bottom of the sea, throw some iron balls to equalize the gravity and buoyancy. So this way, the submersible can remain suspended. When it goes to float, throw a few more iron balls to make the buoyancy greater than gravity, and the submersible can float back to the surface. Sounds pretty easy, right? But how do people under the water communicate with the people on the surface? How do the scientists operate the robotic arms? And how do they know where their positions is at? These are all very complicated problems to even think of. Thanks to the Chinese scientists, these problems have all been solved. That's all for the video today. And by the way, will there be tons of iron balls at the bottom of the Mariana Trench after all these trials after 1,000 years? If you have any opinions about this, you can comment down below. Thank you for watching my video, and I'll see you in the next one.